Hi, and welcome to today's segment of So You're Going to the Electric Chair. Today we have Grant and Jefferson. See, Jefferson, he was wrongfully accused of a crime of a murder, and he was convicted as guilty. So now he's going to the electric chair in approximately 1 week, and apparently he felt bad about that, and Grant was the person who helped him feel as though he was a man. We also have Vivian and Tanti Lu, who helped Grant with inspiring him to make Jefferson feel better. So let's welcome them. Jefferson.
Hi.
Welcome.
Nice.
Graham.
How are you?
I'm fine.
This is Vivian.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
And this is Tanti Lu.
Hi.
Hi.
So, how is everybody today?
I'm fine. All right. Yeah.
Well, it's nice to know that Jefferson's fine because, you know, you're going to the electric chair in approximately 1 week, right?
Yeah, it's about a week. I'm kind of sad about that, though.
Why are you so sad about that?
Because, I mean, who really wants to die? You're not going to be living no more. And I'm glad I'm not dying of hunger, though, because Grant, he made me a man.
I understand. It must have been so hard for you.
Yeah. Well, at least I can make my godmother proud, because she always wanted me to be something.
Your godmother, Miss Emma.
Yeah. But at least I'll be a man, not a hog going to that chair.
I also think it's kind of, you know, messed up because, you know, the reason why he's going to electric chair is because he was wrongfully accused of murder.
Yes, wrongfully accused. We know that you didn't commit the crime, and it must have been really hard for that. But apparently Grant was the person who helped you with that. And
yeah.
Grant, what inspired you to help Jefferson with this?
Well, my darling Vivian is what pretty much push me.
Hey, I'll push you, okay?
Look, woman, stop nagging me.
Don't give me that attitude.
How many times do I have to tell you? Stop nagging me. As I was saying, my dear Vivian inspired me to talk to Jefferson. At first, I thought it was impossible. I mean, what kind of task is it to change somebody into a man? Downright, you know, impossible to do. So I couldn't believe it, but the thought of having Vivian with me is what pushed me. Plus, if I would do anything, I mean anything, to be with Vivian, and you know, she's my world, but later on I felt that going to see Jefferson had a deeper meaning to it, especially for me as a teacher. Because I felt that just teaching children wasn't just enough, because they grew up, and once they grow up, they go into the work field, and they go on with their lives. But with Jefferson, it was different. Also, it's a different feel for him, because I had to change him from a hog to a man. It wasn't easy.
Well, it was nice that Vivian, you were the person who inspired Grant. Now, what did you do? Why did you help Grant in the first place?
Well, I think Grant, he really needed someone there for him, because, you know, he always put himself down and said, I can't do it. How am I supposed to do this? I can't change a man from a hog to, I can't change a guy from a hog to a man. How am I supposed to do it? Well, I'm like, you know, Grant, Jefferson really needs you right now, you know? And I just think that Grant needed someone to come to have that push. Because I think deep down inside that Grant really needed someone to show a deeper meaning for his teachings. Because like you said, you know, he taught the kids won't use education to go out in the work field. But with Jefferson can actually use it to make himself feel better, to become a man, and thus please himself, Grant, and Miss Emma.
Well, that was very nice of you, Vivian. Grant, it's nice to know that you have such a strong woman by your side, but apparently you also grew up with another strong woman, your aunt, Tanti Lu, and didn't she help you as well? Now, Tanti Lu, what did you do to help him?
I encouraged him to go to Grant and talk to him.
Look, woman, I told you I appreciate it, but Vivian is who pushed me, alright? So stop nagging me.
Well, you know, it's interesting that you're being so mean to Yaron in such a society in the time period that you live in. There is segregation going on. How does that make you feel? Does that make it hard for you?
I mean, as a black man, I'm put down by the white man. White people, they just look down on us, treat us as dirt.
Yeah.
And us black people, we feel that it's not right.
Yes.
It's not right.
It's not right at all.
So,
yeah.
Making Jefferson, I can understand where Miss Emma's coming from. Making Jefferson from a hog to a man, you know, will definitely shut down the white people and their views of us.
So, you say a hog to a man. Apparently, this was rumored to have come up at the trial for you. And can you elaborate upon that?
Well, my attorney, my defender.
Yes.
He called me a hog when he was trying to defend me, make me look like I didn't do the crime. But he called me a hog, and I thought, like, okay, he's a white man, he's calling me a hog, I guess I'm a hog, I'll die a hog. But my aunt didn't want that. She wanted me to die a man so she could be proud of me.
Yes.
So she sent Griff.
It's fine, don't worry, you'll be okay.
He sent Grant to make me a man.
Don't worry.
It's hard. Yeah, so I'm gonna die a man now.
You will die a man, and it's nice to know that it was Grant who helped you so much to inspire you and make you realize you're a man. And we'll speak more upon that after these brief messages. Thank you.
Ever wished that you had a blanket with arms when you're really, really cold? Well, this is your chance with a Snuggie. Look at it. It's warm and fuzzy, and you can get whatever pattern you want. And they even make them for your pets. So you have arms, and you don't even have to worry about your arms getting cold. See, look how soft it is, and it's so big. For only 3 easy payments of $14.99, you can have your own Snuggie today. It's my Snuggie.
Welcome back to today's segment of So, You're Going to the Electric Chair. And as you know, we have Jefferson, who was going to the electric chair for a crime which he did not commit. And he had felt like he was a hog, and Grant is the person who made him realize he was a man. So, Grant, what was it that you specifically did to help Jefferson feel as though he was a man?
Well, pretty much I brought him a radio and a journal. Radio was for him to connect with the outside world, especially because he was confined in that cell of his. And so I felt that the radio would possibly connect him and make him more human-like rather than a hog. And as for the journal, well, I gave him the journal because I felt that every time I went to go visit Jefferson, he had some deeper feelings that he wouldn't talk to me about. And every time I looked into his eyes, I felt I saw a whole world of thoughts running through his head. So why not another way of trying to get it out? So I gave him the journal, thinking he could possibly write everything out and possibly get everything off his chest. And it helped out in the end.
Well, it's nice to know that you've done that, but Jefferson, did that actually help? Do you feel as though you're a man because of what Grant gave you?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, the radio, it's something that a man uses, and I never really used it before. I mean, I had listened to music before I was called a hog, so it brought me back to that. And the fact that hogs can't ride, because all they do is walk on their 4 feet, so it was nice to know that I could actually do some things that a man can do, so it made me feel even more like a man. And I also wanted Grant to have my notebook before I do die, so he can read all the deep thoughts that I did have.
Well, it's nice to know that you feel as though you're a man when you're in Proxima and Love a Week. You're going to the electric chair, right? And you're gonna die in 1 week, so I'm glad I'm not in your position. But anyways, as I was saying, we ended this segment of So You're Going to the Electric Chair, and come back next week as you will see Freddy Krueger, and I will be interviewing him. So, Miss Emma.
Come on, guys, it's time for to eat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fried chicken.
Wait, was I supposed to record that?
Fried chicken.
Yes. Yes.
You're supposed to record.
Oh, okay.
You didn't record that?
Yeah, I did. I did.
Are you still recording?
Yeah. Okay.